Hi, welcome to another episode of This Is My Architecture. I'm David John, and I have with me Lakhan from ZS Associates. Hi, Lakhan. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for having me.
So let's get started. Tell us something about ZS Associates.
ZS is a global professional services firm where we provide technology, analytics, and strategy consulting to various clients across the industry. We have a keen focus on life sciences and their various functions.
Great. So we are here to talk about your self-service enterprise data engineering platform. What does this platform do?
Yeah, so for in life sciences, if it start to grow, different function becomes more and more data-driven. They often start to face challenges while scaling their analytics journey. For example, they start to face challenge in building those data integration and ingestion pipeline. Second challenge they face is the turnaround time they require to spin up the infrastructure, which is consistent, compliant, secure, because it often requires deep tech skill or multiple approval across different agencies. Third challenge faced by data analysts and data scientists by time they took to discover data sets in a data lake and get access to the data sets. What we have here is a self-service enterprise data engineering platform, which tries to solve those typical challenges with the key goal of shorter time to market for these functions, security at scale, all with the optimal cost.
Oh, I completely agree with the challenges you've highlighted, and there's some good set of goals you set right at the start. So let's dive a bit deeper. So who are these users and how do they interact with the platform?
Yeah, so our first user are data engineer who want to set up an infrastructure for their application. Let's say, so they log into our self-service web portal where they select the type of infrastructure. It could be a batch ETL, it could be real-time change data capture type of a pipeline, or it could be a custom multi-tier web application. Once they make the choice, they also have to provide cost center or project code information, which we eventually use to charge back. Once the selection is made, our portal makes a REST request to EKS, where a service running on EKS creates a request record in Postgres with all the metadata information, and then creates an event on SQS, which in turn trigger a workflow, automation workflow, for infrastructure provisioning. After the workflow is completed, again, the service sends a notification using SES with all the information about the infrastructure provision back to the request tree.
So that's impressive automation, I should say. So I want to dive a little bit deeper. I want to know what happens when the user actually submits the job.
Yeah, so as I said, there is an event sent to SQS which provisions the infrastructure. What happens here is there is another job in EKS which picked up this message and take various action based on the requested infrastructure type. Let's say it is a batch ETL. The first action it will take is creating an EMR cluster. Then it will create various databases in Glue catalog. Then it creates S3 buckets and launches an EC2 with containerized Airflow or NiFi, where data engineer will be running those data engineering pipelines. And then lastly, create IAM role, which integrates all of these resources. At the end, it will again send a message using SES with all the information about project resources provisioned and how to access them back to the user.
It's good. The orchestration pipeline uses a lot of AWS services. It's fantastic. But with this much of automation, I'm curious to understand, how do you manage the data governance, security, and discovery part of it?
Sure. Well, first thing I'll tell is all of our data sits on various S3 bucket across AWS account. What we have done is control the access to this S3 bucket through Glue catalog. So everything accessed through Glue catalog. We have crawlers running in EKS, which crawls the changes in metadata and make it available in our self-service portal as a data discovery dashboard. That's when users like data analyst and scientist come to this dashboard, selects different data sets they need access to, and hit request. After this, most of the automation is same as infrastructure provisioning, with a key change in the requested data set has to be approved by data owner. So before we provision anything, we use SES to notify data owner to accept those requests. Once they accept it, it triggers a event in SQS, again followed by a job running in EKS, which then updates IAM role, or it updates Ranger policy if it requires fine-grained access control. And again, after at the end, sends the same information about the data access provision back to the requester.
Right. So you even have manual approvals in your orchestration pipeline.
Yeah.
And the way I see it, it's the glue catalog and IAM, which are the crucial services which help you to data discovery, security, and governance. Fantastic. I'm interested to know the scale of this platform. Do you want to talk about it?
Sure. At this point in time, our EKS hosts 100 plus microservices. Of course, many of these microservices are supporting these workflows and UI portal, but large part of this is reusable data engineering services. For example, so there are services for compute lifecycle management. There are services for different data processing. There are services for data quality rules, running quality rules on data sets. All these reusable services, on a rough scale, we receive millions of API requests every month and hundreds of data access requests per month from data analysts and data scientists.
So I assume your platform services are running on EKS at scale, and your application setup, all the applications are running in EMR. Fantastic. So what were some key challenges which this platform has addressed for you?
Yeah, like I said in before, these are some of our key goals from the platform, which is shorter time to market for our functional teams, right? The way we achieved is automating data access governance workflow, which before this used to take 6 weeks, now it takes few hours with a human in the loop who approves the request. The infrastructure provisioning, which used to take month with all the approvals needed from security and compliance agencies, now it takes few minutes. The other data engineering reusable services helped reduce the build of data engineering pipeline by 30 to 40% for our engineers. Secondly, the security at scale. We have baked in all the security requirement needed to provision this provision infrastructure and governance flow. For example, anonymization, masking, encryption, and fine-grained access control. We controlled the cost by using auto-scaling capability of EKS and EMR. Additionally, everything getting provisioned through this platform is tagged, which gives them gives the functional team ability to keep a check on expenses every month.
Oh, it's fantastic. This goal seemed very challenging at the start of the conversation, but I'm really surprised how your data engineering platform was able to meet those goals using so many AWS services. Thanks a lot, Lakhan, for being on the show. Thank you for watching This Is My Architecture.